In this video, I'll be working on two sign projects. The first is a commission for one of my patrons on Patreon. He asked for a house sign named The Redlands, and for that I'll be using a piece of what I first thought was a wood called Util or Utile, I'm not sure how you pronounce that. But after posting a picture of the sign on Instagram, a couple of people have commented saying that it's potentially walnut. I'm not sure, but whatever it was, it looked like a really nice piece of wood. You can see here in the corner where I used my hand plane to get a better look at the grain. I bought this piece several months ago as an offcut at my local reclamation yard. And the second project is to rename this sign for my parents' summer house. This is a piece of log sliced at an angle, and I'm not sure what wood this is either. I worked on these projects a few weeks apart from one another, but rather than making two short videos, I thought it would be interesting to combine the two projects into one video. First, I needed to prepare the wood for the two projects. The summer house sign was painted black with some white stickers on, which were beginning to flake off. The sign was poorly made, and you can barely even tell that this is a piece of wood underneath all of that paint. I first used my heat gun and a filler knife to help remove the paint from the faces. As soon as the paint started to bubble up, it scraped off pretty easily. And I did the same again on the back of the sign too. For the edges of the sign, I couldn't remove the paint so easily from the bark, so I decided to just burn it off using my blowtorch. I wore a respirator while doing this because I didn't want to breathe in any dodgy paint fumes. I then used a wire brush to clean off some of that charred wood. Basically, what I was trying to do is make this look more like tree bark again, and it worked out pretty well. To further clean up the faces, I used my belt sander, starting with 40 grit and then 80 grit. I didn't want to get it perfectly smooth, I wanted to retain some of that character, like the bandsaw blade marks on the wood. And as I had my blowtorch out, I thought I'd have some fun adding a bit of colour to the face of the sign. I did that mostly around the edges to give the sign kind of like a border or a vignette kind of effect. For the house sign, to prepare whatever sort of wood this is, I ran it through the thickness planer. If this was a piece that I was preparing for a piece of furniture or something, then I would joint one face and then thickness plane the opposite face to get it perfectly flat and consistently thick. But this piece was pretty good and straight anyway, and as it's a sign, it doesn't really need to be prepared to that extent. I got the wording printed up in the font that the client wanted, and I used a glue stick to stick it to the face of the wood. And here I'm just checking that I stuck it on straight. I chose a V-groove router bit for this, that way I could adjust the cutting depth of the bit to get the right thickness for the letters. And I used a speed square to help guide the base of the router to keep the vertical lines nice and straight. I did the curves freehand. I'm using a trim router here, but the better tool to use is probably a plunge router so that you can plunge down into the wood more safely to get the cuts started. I do have a plunge router, but I've never really liked using it. For some reason, I much prefer using a trim router with one hand, and I just keep a really firm grip on it, especially when plunging down at an angle, but I wouldn't recommend doing it this way, it's just what I'm more comfortable with. I used an old chisel to scrape the paper off. The letters looked really good, but they did need a bit of cleanup work, which I did with a sharp chisel. Like here on the H, where I slipped with the speed square a little bit while routing. That serves me right for not clamping the speed square down. For the summer house sign, I used an ordinary straight router bit for that instead of the V-groove, because these letters were thicker, so I couldn't just do them in one pass. And I couldn't use a speed square on this sign because there was no straight edge to reference off, so I just did it all freehand. By the way, Digby is the name of my mum and dad's cat, who spends a lot of time in the summer house.
The original name on the sign was Jessica, and it was like that when they moved into the house. Maybe Jessica was a cat too, who knows? It was really difficult to see what I was doing here because I was wearing a respirator and that kept fogging up my safety glasses, so I had to keep stopping to give them a clean. Then I could chisel the edges of the letters square, and it was really difficult because I was chiseling into end grain, so getting the bottom of the letters smooth was really tricky. I used an exterior grade white paint for the lettering, and once dry, I recoated. I think it got 3 coats in total. Back to the house sign now, and the client wanted a leaf from a copper birch tree on the sign, and he kindly sent me this photo. I first made some reference marks for the size I wanted the leaf to be, and then I sketched out a leaf freehand. Once I was happy with that, I went over the pencil marks with a Sharpie so that they were more visible. I raised the route a bit here so that the lines for the leaf would be thinner, and I did the freehand routing just following the lines. I did the same on the opposite side of the sign too, marking up the same size, but this time with the leaf mirrored. I thought I had some artist paint brushes, but I couldn't find any, so I ended up using a larger brush and just cutting down the bristles. Then I could apply paint to the leaf and all of the letters too. Again, I applied 3 coats here. Then with an 80 grit sanding belt, I could remove the excess paint from both signs using my belt sander. And I used my air blower to clean off any dust. For finish, I decided to use teak oil on both signs. This showed up some areas where I hadn't completely removed some of the white paint from the grain of the wood, so I used a knife blade to scrape that away and applied oil again. The end grain really soaked up the oil quickly, so I just kept reapplying, leaving it for half an hour or so, and then wiping away any excess and repeating that until it completely stopped soaking in. That should give the signs a good level of protection from moisture. I did some sanding with my random orbit sander on the house sign to remove any marks left by the sanding belt. I also planed the edges of the sign using my hand plane, and I added a subtle roundover to the front edges too. Then I added my maker's mark to the back of each of the signs. On the house sign, some of the teak oil got into the V grooves of the letters. So I ended up going to buy some artist's paintbrushes just so that I could freshen up that white paint again.
Here are a few pictures of the finished signs. This was my first time making signs and they were quick projects to do and I think they turned out really nicely. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe if you haven't already for more weekly woodworking videos, and thanks for watching. Thank you.